What's up, guys? Welcome to this month's episode of the Wilki Show. So this month we've got several cast members from the Southern Girls High School, Southern Boys High School production, We Were Rocky. So let's get in to the questions. So I'll let these people introduce themselves first.
Kia ora, Wilki Show. I'm Levi Te Amo. Thank you so much for having me on.
Hi, I'm Elliot.
Hi, I'm Amelie, and I play.
So, the first question is, what character did you portray in We Were Rocky, and what motivated you to choose that role?
So, I portrayed the role of Galileo Figaro in our production of We Were Rocky. So, I didn't actually go for Galileo initially. I went for another character. But once I was recalled for Galileo, and I got to read for him, I realised, yeah, no, this could be more me than the other one. And honestly, I think I really grew into it. I really enjoy playing the eccentric kind of crazy characters. It's just my style, as evidenced by my last two productions, those being SpongeBob as SpongeBob and Elf as the Elf.
Part of the ensemble in the production We Will Rock You.
And I played Oz in the Southland Girls High School, Southland Boys High School 2024 senior production of We Will Rock You. I chose to audition for the production because I had a really fun time doing junior production last year as year 10. I had so much fun, I met so many amazing people and got to spend lots of time with them as well during rehearsals, so that was something that motivated me. Something that I thought was really cool about Oz is that she has such a beautiful song, like No One But You is amazing, it has such amazing music and amazing lyrics, and it's got such a great meaning too behind it, being like a tribute to Freddie and all. Something, because with the audition materials, we didn't really get to see much of the characters. But when I got cast as Oz, I found out that she's like such an amazing personality. She's so sassy and she's like, she has so much depth to her. Like on the surface, she is so sassy and she like hates everything, but she loves everything actually. And maybe she just seems that like she hates everything because she cares about everything so much. And she has so much depth to her, which is something I never realized. And especially with her song, I feel like they add so much.
The next question is, how would you describe your experience leading up to the performance?
Spectacular. Absolutely incredible. I really enjoyed the entire rehearsal process. It was so much fun. The creative team were so easy to work with. As were the cast. We had a really dedicated ensemble, great group of dancers, as they do every year, and everyone was so talented, and it was such an honour to be working with such cool leads, especially as a year 11, getting right into it, for my first, actually full show. I think there was no better way to do it. I think getting right into it, being these big characters, alongside such talented co-stars, it was awesome. I really enjoyed it, and working with Queen Music too, it was just awesome. But yeah, it was so fun going to rehearsal each of the nights, and going home with all the songs stuck in my head, singing them over and over and over again, much to the annoyance of my parents, but you know. I gotta say the best part of the experience leading up to the show was the first run at the school with, everyone in costume. It was so cool. Especially Harlan's costume. Harlan has the best costume, like, no doubt. Jess is a close second. It's just so cool. And he did that himself. And his dad. But that was like, it's the coolest thing ever. And it was like, oh, this show is actually just, it's going to be amazing. And I was so hyped for it. Unfortunately, we all managed to get sick right before production week. So that was just brilliant, you know, after all those rehearsals. But you know, it's fine. Everyone pushed through and, it is what it is, but it only made us go harder, I think. I think we just put so much more effort into it because, oh well. Like, no time for sickness. Even despite that, yeah, we had an amazing run, and such great audiences, and it was just such a good show. I really enjoyed it, and I really miss it. It's just, I don't know what I'm doing with my life now. Come see Mamma Mia. Come.
I auditioned for the production because a few of my friends wanted me to.
That was a good one.
Me too, and I thought it would be a good experience. It would be good to get to know how theatre works. It would be good to like just spend time with my friends. It would be fun, and I was right. It was so fun. I did miss a month worth of rehearsals because I was overseas, but for the few that I was at, I could see that everyone was working really well together. They all got along. The vibes in the theatre were just really, really good vibes. It was a privilege working with everyone.
My experience leading up to the performance was an interesting one. I feel like we kind of had a disadvantage, especially because we had school holidays and the girls in France away for quite a lot of the rehearsal period. But I feel like the cast, we all united together and we put on, you know, felt the pressure and felt the need to put on a great show and like defend together to be able to do the show justice, and I think we did.
The next question is, what was your favourite scene in the show and why did it make it special for you?
I'm going to have to say that the Heartbreak Hotel scene, the first one at the end of Act 1, was my favourite scene because it had everyone involved, all the cast members playing their characters, Madonna, Mick Jagger, Janis Joplin, Boy George, and AC/DC, etc. Probably got the funniest lines in the entire show. I think it was just... it was really fun every time, in rehearsal and in the actual performance space. And Harlan really made it incredible with his Britney Spears speech. It was great every time. Jack too. Jack, you play a really good hippie. It was just spot on. So fun working with him. It was so fun working with everybody. It was so cool getting to talk to these people that I otherwise wouldn't have met, I bet. Because, you know, they're all way too cool for me, but that's okay. And yeah, what made the scene special to me was the entire cast involvement. I just think there was a lot of energy every time we did it, and it was so awesome. The audience loved it.
My favourite scene in We Will Rock You would probably have to be Crazy Little Thing Called Love. Everyone's just so smiley and happy in it, and I love just making up the dance as I go, and, like, I don't know, the crowd, you could... feel the crowd could love that scene as well.
My favourite scene in the show has to be the bit leading up to Who Wants to Live Forever and Who Wants to Live Forever. I think it's just such a beautiful tender moment between Galley and Scaramouche. Every night in the wings I would like say the lines to my friend and we'd act out the whole scene, and it's so beautiful. I love it so much. And Who Wants to Live Forever is my favourite song in the whole show as well, which is crazy.
So, the last song is, what song did you enjoy performing and why did you like it?
Personally, I enjoyed Crazy Little Thing Called Love the most. Coincidentally, that's part of my favourite scene, but, you know, Harlan absolutely nailed that song every time. It's so cool. Not to mention, like, all the dancing and the entire ensemble getting really into it. I think that's what made it really cool for me. And then, also because I just had like the least amount of singing in that song, I had the I gotta be cool and relax, get fit and get on my tracks part. And that was it. And it was easy, it was fun. And you could tell the entire time that the audience was really into it as well. It was awesome.
My favourite song that I enjoyed performing would either have to be Crazy Little Thing Called Love because of the vibes. We Will Rock You because it's just so energetic and it's a crowd favourite, or No One But You because Amelie did a really good job of singing it, and it's just such a catchy song. It gets stuck in your head. So, yeah.
My favourite song to perform in the show has to be I Want It All or No One But You, of course. Harlan and I, who played Brit, we had such a fun time like jamming out to I Want It All and Headlong. But I feel like I Want It All, especially, is like we're talking about our dreams and what we want. And I think it's just such a cool song. We had such a fun time jamming out to it. And of course, with No One But You, you know, it's such a beautiful song. It's like such a tender and somber moment between, you know, Oz and the audience as well as the ensemble. It's just such a great moment because we're all united. Like, the entire ensemble is united in singing about, you know, people who died too young. I think it's just such a beautiful and tender moment between everyone that's experiencing it.
Awesome. Overall, it was an incredible show, incredible cast, incredible tech team. But yeah, thank you so much for having me on your show.
Now we've got an audience perspective.
Hey guys, we're just doing a quick review on We Will Rock You. Natalia's going to start us off. So from an audience perspective, it was really interesting and cool to watch. I think the songs were really fun and upbeat.
My perspective, it was great, you know. Yeah, it was okay. Great. Ensemble, great dancers, Levi was amazing, tech team was amazing, shout out to Jacob, you know.
Yeah, good job Jacob, great. It was really good.
Yeah, what else? I think it's good.
Yeah.
What do you rate it?
Team
I rate it 9.72 probably. Yeah, anyways, keep your half.
Now we've got a perspective from someone in the stage crew.
Hi, my name's Tim, and I was the assistant stage manager for the We Will Rock You production. Basically, just that involves doing stage manager stuff, passing out props to the characters, etc. Now, I didn't actually mean to do the production, because I didn't audition for part of the ensemble, or any part. However, for part of my theatre tech class, I do get some credits for being in the production or in some sort of electronic media scene. Anyway, I got credits for it. I didn't mean to do it. I ended up doing it and I loved it. It was really great. Yeah. My role basically was managing one side of the stage. Now, my side of the stage, stage right, bit less busy than the other one. So all I had to do was turn on the lights every so often for the green screen, pass out props to characters, take a prop in every so often. And yeah, that's it. Favourite thing about my job, it's just got to be the whole energy around it, eh? The people in the production are fantastic, really. They're great. And the whole energy about the production in general was just encouraging, real positive energy of, let's go out and do this thing. Yeah, it was great. Favourite scene, it's got to be the ending one at Wembley Stadium. Yeah, I mean, I get to do the most on that scene because we have to take the bike and the motorbike from the previous scene and push the guitar out, which is a pretty cool moment, getting to do that. Yeah, so that's what makes it my favourite scene. And I'm just glad I did it. You know, I wasn't going to do it originally, but I ended up doing it as part of my grade, and I really liked it. Yeah.
Rock on!
Thank you for having me on the show, Jacob.
I'm really sad that the show is over, though. I had such an amazing time with this cast, and especially with the audience. So thank you to everyone who came and watched it, and thank you to everyone who was in the show.
One last thing. Levi wants to do some promotional stuff, so I'll let him do
it. I guess while I'm on such a famous show, I'll shamelessly promote IMT's run of Mamma Mia, running July 12th to the 27th. I'm doing backing vocals for that, along with Mace Bredo, who's also in the We Were Rocking production. It's going to be so awesome. It's going to be so great. It's going to be the best. Come see it. Thanks so much for having me.